You. Thank you for tuning in. I have a word for you today, a word of encouragement. I read in the Bible a scripture that really blessed my heart so much, and I believe it's for you. And I want to speak to you about hope in the midst of hopelessness. Hope in the midst of hopelessness. And this scripture was coming from the book of Amos. Amos is one of those books which most of the people don't read them. And Amos chapter 9 from verses 11 to 15, that's what it says. But also on that judgment day, I will restore David's house that has fallen into pieces. Now listen to that. I want to expound this a little bit, because we are in the same problem or the same predicament as it was during the time of Israel this time. Amos is one of the minor prophets, but Israel has gone through a lot of troubles. They feel they have gone through a judgment, as Kenyans and the whole world are feeling this time. Because of the pandemic, which we have been experiencing in this time of COVID-19, people say, is this God's judgment? What is it? But listen to what the Lord says. But on that judgment day, I will restore David's house. Remove David and put your house and put in the nation of Kenya that has fallen into pieces. I will repair the holes in the roof, replace the broken windows, fix it up like new. David's people will be strong again. What about that? David's people will be strong again and seize what is left of their enemy, Edom, plus everyone else under the sovereign judgment. This is God's decree. He will do this. Now listen to verse 13, what it says. Yes, he did. It won't be long from now. That is a promise of God. God says, although this pandemic has taken so long, we thought it was going to be 1 month, 2 months, now 3 months plus that. In fact, it's over 100 days since it was announced in Kenya. And it's still going on. The curve is still going on very steep. And we were waiting for this time to see it flattening. And this is what God is saying. He says, yes, indeed, it won't be long before he flattens it. Things are going to happen so fast that your head will swim, one thing after the other, over the heels of one another. You will not be able to keep up. Everything will be happening at once and everywhere you look. Blessings, blessings, blessings. They will be pouring like wine pouring out of the mountains and the hills. And I'll make everything right again for my people. That is a lot of hope. I will make everything right again for my people. That's what God says. Listen, he says, you will rebuild the ruined cities, the ruined business, the ruined things. These 3 months of 100 days, we have been like as if hiding. Things have gone wrong. Businesses have gone down. Jobs are no more. And the Lord said, you will rebuild them again. You will plant vineyards and drink good wine. They will work in their gardens and they will eat the vegetables. And you will plant them and plant them on your own land. They will never again be uprooted out of their land again. Thus says the Lord. Wow. When you read such a scripture like that, it sounds not like it is BC. It sounds like it is AD. And this is because the promises of God are yeah and amen. And as we begin this week, child of God, I want to encourage you. All that what you have lost in the last while, all of it is going to come cumulatively, and God is going to restore. I want you to know the promise of God is moving us from hopelessness to hope. It's going to restore all that what you have lost. And whatever you have lost, God will double it. I pray that you'll be strong. Listen to the word of God. Read the word of God. Be strong in faith, and you'll see what God is going to do for you. So begin the week with vigor and with joy. For God, even our God, is with you. Amen.